here.
Really?
The assurance card that states that the diamonds and the jewelry are from the iconic Argyle mine in Western Australia.
Good afternoon, everybody. I think I'm honored to be associated with Australian Diamond as brand ambassador. And as he rightly said, that for me earlier, Australia is a fiercely competitive team. I look forward to beating them on the field, and also touring Australia. It was landscapes and kangaroos, but now I have another reason to look forward is the Australian Diamonds, and I think it gives me joy to be associated with this brand. And also for one unique reason is that, as he again mentioned about the tracking system and a certificate to assure consumers how, if they're spending so much on a diamond, they should be aware and have a knowledge about the diamond that they're going to own comes from. It is ethically sourced and from an iconic and trusted mine. So I think overall, I relate to most of the values, and I'm truly honored to be a part of this family. It is too early for me to comment on the new coach, but yes, I have interacted with him when he was in National Cricket Academy, and there is, I think as a one-day captain, now that we have a very important tour in January, it's important that we focus on getting the team together, because it's an ICC championship one-day as where the point system is in place, and it's important for India to garner as many points as we can, because it will help us in the 2021 One-Day World Cup. As far as women coaches, I'm of a belief that, the best coach, whether it is male or a female, doesn't matter. As long as you are the best coach suited for the job, you should be picked to coach the Indian team, because it's a national team. So I don't think I would give so much of importance for gender here. The few days, which is, it's been very stressful for me, for my parents, and also for people around me, because the way it has panned out. And it definitely did get women's cricket a spotlight, which was not needed, because when you talk about non-cricketing issues of players and the team, the focus goes away from the sport. So now that we have a tour again, I believe that it is time that we move forward, look forward, and be more optimistic and positive going forward. I can't say, I can't talk about 2020, but I still have 2019 to go forward to, and I'm looking forward for a great year for me and for my team, because we have a lot of cricket coming up, and it's important that now we have to move on from here, because it's important that the sport is back in focus, and we need to work on building a very strong team. When it comes to central contracts or giving one-time benefit for ex-cricketers, because I believe that was important, as most of the ex-cricketers have played in an era where there was no money, no financial support, and there was no job opportunities for them, whereas now the current generation enjoys a lot of privileges. That is because of their foundation laid in so many years. So I think that has really helped ex-cricketers financially. But overall, I think it is the BCCI is the board, and how BCCI has got women's cricket from 2007 so far to 2018, and how we have got a lot of support from the board in terms of increasing our support staff required those camps, as in when we required, they've always given us those facilities. I think that, as when we are 15 individual players come together with the support staff, it's a huge family, it's a big family, and usually in a family there's always difference of opinion. Everybody could not have a same kind of a perspective, And it does happen, there will be issues, but again, when we take on the field as a national team, when we are ambassadors of a sport and represent so many of you all at the biggest stage, I think these issues are secondary to us. In fact, not even secondary, doesn't come into the list of priorities. When we take on the field, we are one unit, we represent country, and we are there to give our best and perform as a unit. So, and as professional cricketers, as professional athletes, we know that, you know, when we get on the field, we have a job to do. अभी तो हमने मिला भी मिले भी नहीं कि मैं कोई एक्सपेक्टेशंस रखूं, पर ये है कि जो भी नया कोच आता है हमको उनको सपोर्ट देना चाहिए और आगे की सोचनी चाहिए. आगे बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट इंटरनेशनल टूर्स हैं और सीरीज़ हैं जो इंडियन टीम के लिए बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट है, और टीम को साथ में परफॉर्म करना बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट रहेगा, बिकॉज हम लोग न्यूजीलैंड 2007 के बाद जा रहे हैं, तो काफ़ी लंबा ऑलमोस्ट 10-11 ईयर्स के बाद जा रहे हैं. और इस टीम से सिर्फ दो ही लोग हैं, मैं और झूलन गोस्वामी, जिन्होंने पिछला टूर न्यूजीलैंड के लिए किया है, तो रिलेटिवली काफ़ी लोगों के लिए ये पहला टूर है, तो उस हिसाब से ये बहुत चैलेंजिंग टूर रहेगा. और मुझे लगता है कि हमको ज़्यादा इम्पोर्टेंस हमारी प्रिपरेशन में देनी चाहिए. ऑब्वियसली वॉजंट वेरी गुड, नॉट इन अ गुड टेस्ट, एंड इट हैज़ अफेक्टेड एवरीबडी इन अ डिफरेंट लेवल, in a different way, and you know, I'm sure now things are settled and we should be putting more spotlight on the sport, on the players, on the team.
How you
I think it is a very interesting series.
Yeah.
Always it has been, because India Australia are topmost teams, and they play they have this, they get the competitiveness in every player. And even as a fan, as a cricket fan also, I would like to see a very closely fought contest.